On the east bank of the Vistula River, in the Warsaw suburb of Praga, a Jewish boy was born in 1883 and named Menachem, he who brings comfort. His father, Elazar Ziemba, died shortly after, and the boy was raised by his grandfather. He became rapidly known as a dazzling genius and formidable Torah scholar, corresponding with the best Torah minds of his era. Menachem Ziemba married at age 18. His wealthy father-in-law supported him for 20 years while he studied and put pen to paper, authoring over 10,000 pages of original Torah insights, including commentaries on Maimonides' magnum opus and on the Jerusalem Talmud, and four volumes of Halachic responsa. His fame spread globally. He was offered rabbinical positions, including the office of the chief rabbi of Jerusalem, but he humbly shunned leadership. Leadership was thrust upon him in 1935 by order of the Grand Rabbi of Ger. The humble rabbi joined the Warsaw Rabbinate and proved his worth, becoming a world authority on Jewish law and a foremost spokesman for Polish Jewry. Before reaching age 40, Rabbi Ziemba was appointed honorary secretary to Moetzes Gedolei HaTorah, the Council of Great Torah Sages, populated by sages twice his age. In 1937, he twice addressed the full assemblage and was treated with awe. Then the Nazis arrived. Jewish Warsaw was reduced to a ghetto. 460,000 people were imprisoned in just 1.3 square miles. Starvation, disease, deportation, murder. Despite repeated offers of escape, Rabbi Ziemba refused to abandon his flock. To them, he was a rare pillar of comfort. As one of a handful of rabbis who survived in the ghetto until its final days, he rallied his desperate brethren with powerful messages of hope and determination. He recorded an insight into the nature of antisemitism before the war. In light of his subsequent experiences under Nazi depravity, his words ring with timeless poignancy. There are those who seek to identify legitimate causes for the hatred of Jews. However, reality has shown that there is no legitimate reason. Antisemitism has no justifiable cause. The haters simply choose to hate God's people. This is demonstrated by the fact that Jews are hated for being capitalists and also for being socialists. They are hated because they are overly ambitious and sharp-minded, and also because they are indolent and parasitic. They are hated because they are too religious and conservative, and also because they advance progressive and secular ideas. The reasons for this hatred are consistently contradictory and have not an ounce of logic behind them. Shortly before Passover, 1943, the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising erupted. Amid furious fighting and flames, Rabbi Ziemba calmly conducted a Passover Seder as if nothing was amiss. But on the fifth day of Passover, April 24, 1943, Rabbi Ziemba was gunned down by Nazi bullets. The community he shepherded with love and sacrifice came together at terrible risk to bury their beloved rabbi in a temporary grave. His family was deported to Treblinka. None survived. His lifetime of copious writings rose to heaven in the Warsaw fires. Hardly any of it survived. In 1958, his body was exhumed. Tens of thousands of people amassed, including an array of leading Jewish sages, to lay the heroic rabbi to eternal rest in dignity. Reality has proven that this righteous man was right. There is no legitimate reason for the hatred leveled in each generation against the innocent men, women, and children of the Jewish people.